ओके, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। तो लास्ट लेक्चर आई थिंक वी हैव कवर्ड द न्यूमेरिकल्स रिलेटेड टू कैलकुलेशन ऑफ टोटल प्रेशर एंड सेंटर ऑफ प्रेशर फॉर हॉरिजॉन्टल, वर्टिकल एंड इंक्लाइंड प्लेन सर्फेसेस। एंड बिफोर दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द डेरिवेशंस रिलेटेड टू द फॉर्मूले of total pressure and center of pressure on horizontal plane surface, vertical plane surface and inclined plane surface. Okay, so today I request you to solve more and more numericals on this and get the practice. Is it okay? Somebody can chat in chat box. Anything now, doubt is there related to this vertical surface, horizontal surface, inclined plane surface, related to derivations of total pressure and center of pressure? Any doubt, any problems, so that we can continue with the theory. Now, remaining articles are theoretical. Any doubt is there, any problems? No, very good. No problem, Pramod. Okay. Thank you. This kind of introduction I want. Okay. Now, today we'll go for the remaining theory part of the fluid statics. That is, what is meant by buoyancy, what is meant by flotation, then what is stability of a floating body, what is stability of a submerged body, then related to here, equilibrium conditions of floating body, equilibrium conditions of here submerged bodies, and metacentric height. Okay, so this kind of we'll go for. But before that, some formulas will revise, so that I want that how whether you are also studying, whether you are revising. Now after this lecture, if time permits us, time permit me, then what we'll do, I will give some numericals for that remaining period on vertical plane surface and inclined plane surface, and you have to solve some numericals. Okay, now here okay, so I want that total pressure. Now I will write the horizontal plane surface. So everybody have to react our response. Horizontal plane surface. Now for this, what is value of total pressure? I request somebody have to unmute and they have to tell the answer. Horizontal plane surface, what is value of total pressure? Anybody? Total pressure is given by. Anybody can unmute and tell? Anybody can unmute and tell? What is value of total pressure on horizontal plane surface? Or if you are chat box also, you can represent or write the formula. Okay. What is the value of total pressure on horizontal plane surface? Rho g, correct. Rho g, h bar or h, correct. Or because rho g, h bar, okay, and in this case what is that? H is equal to H bar is equal to H star. Okay, what is rho? We'll tell what is rho. It is the density of fluid. Density of fluid in which the surface is submerged. Okay, and center of pressure is equal to H is equal to H bar or is equal to H star. So all for horizontal plane surface, all the points are at equidepth from the free surface. A is the area of here. area of the surface, that horizontal plane surface, h bar is equal to depth of cg of surface from free surface. Okay, then vertical surface. I want that vertical surface. So very simple, vertical surface. Vertical plane surface. What is the value of total pressure TP? Value of total pressure TP. What is vertical plane surface? What is the value of TP? Again, it is going to be anybody?
Rho g h bar.
Rho g h bar. Correct. So all the total pressure for all kind of surfaces, the value is formula is same. Rho g h bar. What is rho? Density. G acceleration due to gravity. A is the area of the vertical plane surface which is immersed in that fluid. And h bar is equal to anybody? H bar is equal to depth of cg of surface from free surface. Okay, and center of pressure cp. Center of pressure cp is equal to what? Here h star is equal to, now I want somebody have to contribute. HCP is equal to, tell somebody, anybody can?
H bar plus IG divided by A into H bar.
H bar, correct. H bar plus IG divided by A H bar. Very good. Now everybody, you have to explain each term. Nikita is telling, na? Okay. So H star is equal to center of pressure. H bar is equal to, already I told, what is H bar? H bar is depth of cg of surface from free surface. Ig is anybody? Ig. Interact. Ig. Moment of inertia, mi of body passing through cg. Okay, A is area, H bar you would know. Okay, so this indicates that center of pressure always lie below center of gravity. Okay, then inclined plane surface. Inclined plane surface, total pressure. Anybody again? Other than Nikita, anybody? Suhas?
Rho g h bar.
Okay, rho g h bar. Again, no problem. So, if you observe all the kind of surfaces, you can take horizontal plane surface, vertical plane surface, or inclined plane surface. Total pressure is equal to rho g h bar, and center of pressure Cp is equal to now tell h star is equal to star.
Star is equal to h bar plus ig sin square theta divided by a into h bar.
Current faculty list. Hey, come sir, come. Sir, come. Sir, on phone, come. Come.
To be renewed after me. If I get time, I will come. Otherwise, I will call you and I will tell you when you should come.
Okay. Today, Kitty, where? Kitty, where? Kadi, which time? Time. येऊन एक वाजता जातील एक 10 मिनिटं लगेच जातील का ओके तुम्हाला सर्क्युलर आहे रेगिंग ओके इन्क्लाइंड प्लेन सरफेस टोटल प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू रो जी एच बार अँड सेंटर ऑफ प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू सॉरी आय वॉज एनीबडी यू समबडी टोल्ड आय रिपीट एच बार
प्लस आय जी साइन स्क्वेअर थीटा डिवाइडेड बाय ए इनटू एच बार
ओके गुड व्हेरी गुड आय जी साइन स्क्वेअर थीटा divided by tail bar. Okay, now here this condition also we can apply for vertical plane surface. So inclined plane surface derivation is there, so this derivation we can apply as it is for all the surfaces, that center of pressure. Now center of pressure for inclined plane surface is h bar plus ig sin square theta divided by h bar. If the surface is vertical, then theta value will be include theta value will be anybody? Kai will, what is the value of theta? 90, okay, for vertical surface. If you understand this inclined plane surface derivation, we can apply this condition to all remaining surfaces, horizontal or vertical. Now, for theta is equal to 90 vertical surface, what is sine theta value? Anybody? What is sine theta? Sine 90.
One.
Sine theta is equal to 1 in that case. And sine square theta will be also 1. So h star will become h bar plus this will be 1. Ig divided by h bar. So we are getting this vertical plane surface. Okay. Next, if horizontal surface will take. Surface will take as horizontal. Then what will be theta value for horizontal surface? Anybody? Theta is equal to what is theta value? Chi r. Theta is equal to
zero.
Therefore, sine zero is equal to zero. Correct? Na? Sine zero is equal to zero. Therefore, this sine square theta will become zero. This entire term will become zero and h star, this will be in that case horizontal surface. Here h star will be equal to h bar. Okay, everybody now remember, today I revised. Now I request everybody, so after 11:30 or some 11:15, if I end my lecture, and I will give some homework, numericals for exercise, numericals for you, and you have to solve the numericals and you have to give the answers maybe to my WhatsApp number or our no problem. Now today we are going to discuss about the buoyant force. What is mean by buoyant force? What is mean by buoyancy and what is mean by center of buoyancy? What is Archimedes principle? What is metacenter? What is metacentric height? And what is equilibrium of floating bodies and submerged bodies? And formula of how to calculate metacentric height. Now, buoyant force. Now, buoyant force, if any object is immersed in a liquid, then the liquid is having tendency to exert a upward force, a thrust force, which is opposite to gravity force. And that force we call it as a buoyant force. And due to the buoyant force, any object, if you immerse, we want to immerse in water or any fluid, definitely it will not immersing here easily, because some buoyant force is going to be exerted by that fluid on that object. And due to that, the object is always going to be lift up. That object is having tendency to buoy up. So buoy up, buoy up. So buoy up means one. You can write this BOY, buoy up, means here it is uplift, or buoy up means to lift. To lift. Okay. Now this is going to be one yellow object is there. Okay. Let us our cylindrical object is there. That we have a wooden piece, we can say. We have immersed in this particular static fluid. This is static fluid because it is not moving. It is called a static fluid. So when it is immersed, due to weight, the force, weight force is always acting in the downward direction. And buoyant force. So this fluid will exert the buoyant force on this object from this surface, entire surface. Okay. And due to that, that surface is having tendency to buoy up or to lift up. And that is called as that force is called as buoyant force. And this buoyant force is always opposite to the weight of that object or gravity. So gravity is always acting in the downward direction. And this buoyant force is acting in upward direction. Everybody, and the point of application, where the buoyant resultant buoyant force is acting, so that the point of application of buoyant force is called as their center of buoyancy. That is called as center of buoyancy. Okay. Now it is denoted by letter B. So buoyant force here, like our center of pressure, we are denoting by P. center of gravity will be G, this will be CG, this will be center of pressure CP, and this will be center of buoyancy we are denoting by B. Everybody got? Anybody in confusion what is meant by buoyant force? So when a body is immersed in a fluid, there is tendency of the fluid to exert force on the submerged body in upward direction. This upward force is same as the weight of the fluid displaced. If the body is in equilibrium condition, this weight of the fluid displaced by the body is known as the force of buoyancy or buoyancy. Okay, don't consider this. So we only this consider because in our book we are having this kind of spelling, buoyancy not there. Otherwise, it will be confusion. It may be correct, but here there will be confusion of the examiners. Those are not knowing this spelling. Another word for buoyancy. So only you consider buoyancy, B-U-O-Y-A-N-C-Y. Okay. So this is uplift force. Okay. Now center of buoyancy. This is going to be what? Center of buoyancy. So it is the point. Center of buoyancy. Center of buoyancy, you can say. So it is the point of body or where the force of buoyancy act, or it is point of application. In short, we can say point of application of buoyant force is called as point of application. Point of application of buoyant force point application of buoyant force point of application of buoyant force is called as center of buoyancy. Is called as center of buoyancy. Okay, where the buoyant force is at, the point of application of buoyant force is called as center of buoyancy and denoted by letter B. Okay, now upward force of buoyancy in equilibrium condition. This is what? In equilibrium condition. If that in static fluid, the weight, if the body is stable in the here in the fluid, static fluid, then upward force of buoyancy is equal to weight of body. So FB is a notation for buoyant force. So buoyant force is denoted by letter FB. You can say the denotation letter will be FB, and point of application of buoyant force is equal to here center of buoyancy and denoted by letter B. Okay. So in equilibrium condition of static fluid, here if the object's condition, what we can say, weight of that particular object or body is equal to here buoyant force up exerted by the fluid in upward direction, so that body will stable. Now anybody having confusion, doubt, understood, please write and write down the definition buoyant force. Please chat, discuss. Anybody? Yes, Nikita Paur understood. Okay, only Nikita Paur understood. Others, please write. Please respond.
Hello, sir. Sir, anybody is water madhe ek particular height parent devun thevla tar te tithach rahate ka sir, due to buoyant force?
No, now buoyant, but it depends on again. That will come. I will come to later again. Now. Depending on the density, that buoyant weight is here. Weight force is now depending on the density of that particular body. Okay, so it is mass into acceleration. So mass is equal to rho into volume. Okay, so rho, if the density of that body is too much higher, okay, too much higher, and it weight of that particular body is going to be more than the buoyant force in any case. Then that body will not be remaining this way. It will go in the, it will submerge, okay, and in this particular static fluid, and it will go at the bottom side. If the body is now, here equilibrium condition is there, buoyant force is equal to weight of object, and then in that case it will be submerged like this in middle, okay. And if buoyant force is going to be greater than the density of that particular object or weight of that object, in that case resultant weight, then in that case that body may float on this particular object. Now depending on that, if we take example, if we take example of wooden block, okay, it may, if the density, if the weight of that wooden block is exactly equal to buoyant force, so in that case it may, in between that it may remain stable, okay. If you take example of any leaf of any page or leaf of tree, then if it will be immersed, in that case its weight is going to be very small, and in that case buoyant force value is going to be more. So in that case the body, that leaf or that leaf of tree or leaf of that paper will not submerge into that fluid. It will remain on this particular surface only, free surface only, and it will float. So that is called condition of floating. Okay, now when ships are going, now here in the concept of ship, this we are learning because we have to design the ships, okay, when the ships are going into this particular sea, etc. Okay, so in that case, how to design ship? So in that case, this concept of buoyant force, weight of ship, that comes into picture. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I request everybody to write in message box and write down definition of buoyant force. Shall I go to next slide? So buoyant force is denoted by letter FB. So center of buoyancy denoted by letter B. Write on, simply write down our, for our understanding. Point of application of buoyant force, point of application of buoyant force is called as center of buoyancy. So if time permits, next class I will show you the videos, because now these videos are not available, and today I am having some important correlation related work. So up to 11:30 we'll take lecture, and remaining time I will give some two to three numericals for solving this. Point of application of buoyant force is called as center of buoyancy. Okay, now here let us consider a ship. Ship is going to be, here it is floating, is going floating on this particular sea. So if the ship is there, this is, we can say this is point of center of gravity of the ship, and here buoyant force. Now buoyant force means what? Here it is going to be also center of buoyancy will nothing but what, whatever the part of ship, whatever the part of ship which is submerged in the fluid, submerged in water, so this part, so it is exactly, generally it is center of gravity, center of gravity of the part of the object which is immersed in a fluid. ज्या जो भाग त्या शिपचा हा सी मध्ये समुद्रामध्ये बुडालेला आहे त्याची सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी म्हणजे सेंटर ऑफ बॉयन्सी. सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी इथं काय होते, सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी इज गोइंग टू बी, इन दिस केस सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी विल बी हिअर, इट इज अप ऍट अप साइड, अँड सेंटर ऑफ बॉयन्सी विल बी हिअर बिलो साइड, सो सी जी. सो इन दॅट केस लेट आफ्टरवर्ड्स वी विल गोइंग टू डू, सो हिअर जी इज अबोव and center of buoyancy is going to be more. So if for neutral equilibrium condition, it is expected that G and B should be at the same time, same point, okay, buoyancy and center, then their body will not, will be float continuously, and there is no risk. But if this condition will be there, so center of gravity of shifter can change, because depending on the weight of the person, weight of the material that we are going to be loading on this particular ship, And due to that, if the center of gravity goes on changing, if it goes on below, then definitely in that case, the ship may be completely submerged. So therefore, the center of gravity of this particular ship, etc., is very, very, very important. And at the same time, we should know how much center of buoyancy, how much buoyant force is acting, where center of buoyancy is going to be placed, acting. Okay? So G and B, they are playing very important role. Understood? Yes, or chat box. Chat box or nothing? Okay, yes. Okay. Only 3-4, good. Now, related to this, everybody know the Archimedes principle. The Archimedes principle is that when a body is immersed wholly or partially in a fluid, it is lifted up by a force equal to weight of fluid displaced by the body. Now, when a body is immersed wholly or partially in a fluid, it is lifted up by a force equal to weight of the fluid displaced by the body. So when we want to immerse any body, okay, let us consider this body, wholly or partially, then whatever this will displace, if this this cylinder is completely full of water, okay, and if this body we immersed in this particular fluid completely, then what is the weight of that particular cylinder is there? Same amount of water is displaced from this particular tank, and this is called as what? Here this will be nothing but here the Archimedes principle. So weight of fluid displaced by any partially or fully submerged body is equal to weight of that object, okay, or in that case weight of that object is equal to Fb is equal to mg. So when a body is immersed wholly or partially in a fluid, it is lifted up by a force equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by the body. Consider density of immersed body is rho, downward gravitational acceleration force is W, upward force of the liquid buoyancy Fb is equal to m into g. Fb is equal to rho g, Lb, don't worry about it. So everybody got this Archimedes principle? When a body is immersed wholly or partially, write down, when a body is immersed wholly or partially in a fluid, it is lifted up by a force equal to weight of the fluid displaced by the body. Consider density of immersed body is rho, downward gravitational force W, and upward force of the liquid buoyancy Fb is equal to mg. When body is immersed wholly or partially in a fluid, it is lifted up by a force equal to the weight of fluid displaced by the body. Okay. When a body is immersed wholly or partially in a fluid, it is lifted up by a force equal to the weight of fluid displaced by the body. No, in general. So this is going to be weight of the block, and here weight of the body, and not a weight of one, and here Fb is the upward force exerted by the fluid on this object. This is water, immersed in water. So this is upward force and weight is acting through the downward direction. So this weight will acting through the Cg. So here in this condition is there that, and here B. So in this is condition of what? Center of buoyancy is above than the center of gravity. Okay. And in this position, this body will undergo the stable type of equilibrium. After what we will go for. So this is Fb means, this is a figure. The here Fb is nothing but upward force exerted by the fluid on the body, and at the same time, through the CG, the weight of the body is acting in the downward direction. Understood up to this? What is mean by Archimedes principle? What is mean by? Just one minute. Just you draw this figure. आउट ऑफ नहीं कर रहे हो इनका मेडिटेटर मंत्र ना कौन ठीक ये सेटर मंत्र ना आउट ऑफ कर रहे हैं ना कुटली कमिटी कंप्लेंट है ना ये सेटर कैसे है ना कुटली ये कुछ कंप्लेंट एकेडमिक वेल डेगोली सर वो तकरार कर सकते और आउट ऑफ नहीं इन्हीं What is the Rosler? What is the Rosler? Okay, so force of center of buoyancy is acting in upward direction, center of gravity acting in downward direction. Understood? I want a response from your side in chat box. If 10-15 students will give chat box yes, then we'll proceed to next point. If your doubts are there, then please ask. Yes, so thank you. जी थैंक यू निकिता थैंक यू प्रमोद थैंक यू दीक्षा ओके नाउ ओके थैंक यू वेरी मच नाउ वील गो टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज मेटा सेंटर ओके Now consider this is a fluid blue color what is this fluid maybe water and let us consider one body okay this kind of body okay so this body is a having let us consider at point G The center of gravity position G. Okay. Now, here, whatever the part is submerged, its center of gravity is nothing but center of buoyancy. Okay. So G and B point we are knowing. Okay. Now, when such body is in stable condition, okay, equilibrium condition, so meta center always will also lie on the same axis. Now, let us give the clockwise this body is tilt or give some क्लॉकवाइज रोटेशन, तो गिव सम क्लॉकवाइज रोटेशन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर बॉडी, टिल्टेड बॉडी इन क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन, व्हाट विल हैपन जस्ट सी. सो दिस सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी एक्सिस विल बी गेट इंक्लाइंड, बट सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी विल ऑल्सो ऑन द रिमेन ऑन द सेम एक्सिस. बट एज द बॉडी इज गोइंग टू बी डिस्प्लेस्ड, सम पार्ट डिस्प्लेसमेंट डिस्प्लेस्ड पार्ट ऑफ दैट बॉडी विल ऑल्सो गेट वेरी. एंड दिस नाउ डिस्प्लेस पार्ट सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी इज नथिंग बट बॉयंट फोर्स. Now this buoyant force will act now in another, from another axis. Let us consider the axis, new axis of center of buoyancy. This is called as new axis of center of buoyancy. So the it is a intersection point of original axis of the body passing through CG and new axis of center of buoyancy. The intersection point we are calling it as a meta center. So that point is called as meta center, and about that point the body is goes on tilting or oscillating. So that point is called as meta center. So this body is going to be start oscillating on about that point, and that is called as meta center. So when a body is floating in a fluid, is a given a small angular displacement, it start oscillating about a point, that is called as meta center. And it is denoted by letter capital M. So in examination they may ask what is meta center. So meta center is a point of, or it is a point about which body start oscillating when small angular displacement is given to us. So that is called as meta center. So what is again another definition of meta center by this here figure? Okay, that is it is the intersection point of the original axis of original axis of center of gravity and new axis of here new axis of center of buoyancy. That point is called as center meta center intersection point. Understood? Draw diagram and write down the definition of meta center. Okay. दिली कट कसे सांग कुठलं कुठलं ते मग ते टाकू आपण एखादे विद इन वीक कसं कधी कधी काय होते काय रिअल केस मध्ये काय होते कधी कधी ऐकाय नाही आपण ते पण ते हे झाले की ते आवड मग प्रिन्सिपल ऑथॉरिटी दिली ना प्रिन्सिपल त्यातच लिहितील रिमेनिंग होते बरोबर आहे तुमचं आहे बरोबर आहे तुमचं नाही आहे तो 7 डेजचा क्लॉज आहे त्याचा 3 डेज किंवा 7 डेज पण कधी कधी काय झालं माहिती आहे सर काय काय झालंय आपले कम्प्लीट आहेत का नाही कधी कधी महिन्याने झालेत मीटिंग ठीक आहे टाकू आपण तसं चार तास घालवले काल सर चार तास घालवले विचार करून लिहायला कसं लिहिले आता लोक सरांकडे घेऊन जाऊन सर सांगतील करेक्शन जाऊन सांग सांगता गोळी सरांनी केले म्हणा गोळीचं लेक्चर आहेत आणि सांगायचं काय असेल ते करेक्शन घेऊन येईल होईल का म्हणजे हा 2015 सालापासून आपण इम्प्लिमेंट पहिल्यापासून आपण हीच इम्प्लिमेंट करू इम्प्लिमेंटेशन आपलं पहिल्यापासून हीच आहे या इम्प्लिमेंटेशनवर मी रिव्हर्सने सर्क्युलर केले ती मेकॅनिझम मागते हो तिथं मेकॅनिझम एका विद्यार्थ्याची कंप्लेंट आली तर मेकॅनिझम कशी हँडल करायची आपण तक्रार आली हा मेकॅनिझम सगळे सगळे एनी ग्रीव्हन्सेस मेकॅनिझम ते ओके एवरीथिंग इज ओके
हॅलो सर
हां हॅलो हां हां
सर हाऊ बॉडी टिल्ट सर वेदर इट्स ऑटोमॅटिक और वी नीड टू गिव एनी फोर्स
External force, if we want external force, we can also give, no problem. But in sea, wind forces are there now, because sea is, if wind are not coming, then this sea will not tilt, etc. But here, when wind forces are going to be acting on the ship, etc., when it is floating on the sea, at that time, definitely that ship is going to be tilt naturally by wind force. Or due to another case is there that loading of the object we are doing on this particular ship, if the loading is not uniform, or if at one side if the load will become more, at that time so that the ship may get tilt due to wind forces or the loading. Suppose that pass in our boat, we can say the boat. Okay, so boat is there, therefore boat, if persons are not sitting uniformly, then definitely that boat is going to be tilt. Okay, and that metacenter of there, it will start oscillating about one point. That point is called as metacenter. So therefore, when we are going to take ride on boat, if that boatman is asking that you sit uniformly everywhere, so it is not he is giving instruction to us that if maximum people are sitting on one side, so he is asking that to shift that person to another side. So this is the case that body may tilt in that case. Understood?
Yes, sir.
त्या केस मध्ये बॉडी टिल्ट होऊ शकते, म्हणजे आपण तिथे वेट देऊ शकतो आपण तिथं, किंवा तुम्हाला जर प्रयोग करायचा असेल तर आपण बॉडी टिल्ट करू शकतो. एखादा जर समजा आपण एखादी काडी पिटी घेतली आणि ती जर आपण फ्लोटिंग केली, ती आपल्याला जर थोडं टिल्ट केली आपण, तिथे एक्सटर्नल फोर्स द्यावा लागेल. एक्सटर्नल फोर्स म्हणजे ते विंड फोर्स आला, आणि किंवा इंटरनल वेट चेंज. इंटरनल वेट चेंज म्हणजे त्या पोझिशन्स ऑफ वेट डिपॉझिशन. ओके, एव्हरीबडी अंडरस्टूड? I want that everybody should understand this, because this is the your basics behind the statics. And when we want to design ship, so those who are interested in the career to do in what we can call merchant navy, etc., so there is one subject like this, buoyancy, meta center, ship design, one subject is there. And very important, very, there is very law.
Hello, right? Sir.
You can, huh?
Sir, the submarine tilt hota ka, sir?
Submarine tilt hoo shakta na, je kutla object tilt hoo shakta na. त्याचं काय इतर वेळेस टिल्ट कधी त्याच्या इंटरनल रेजिस्टर इंटरनल वेट वगैरे त्याचं चेंज झालं, त्याच्या विंड फोर्सेस त्याच्यावर ऍक्ट होणार जर चेंज झाले तर इट कॅन बी टिल्ट.
सबमरीनला कुठे सर विंड लागतंय आतमध्ये?
नाही, आतमध्ये पण बाकीचे फोर्स आहेत त्याचं सबमरीन. तिथं समजा इंजिनचा ड्रायव्हिंग फोर्स आहे, रेजिस्टन्स फोर्स आहे इंजिनचा, व्हायब्रेटिंग फोर्सेस वगैरे असतील, त्याच्यामध्ये टिल्ट होऊ शकतं. म्हणजे चान्सेस कमी आहेत पण होऊ शकतं. इट इज अ बॉडी ना, एनी बॉडी कॅन बी टिल्टेड इट विच इज इमर्स्ड. त्याला बाकीचे फोर्सेस असतील, समजा समुद्रामध्ये समजा भरती ओहोटी आली तर ते समुद्राच्या जे लाटा वगैरे असतील त्या लाटाच्या पाण्याने होऊ शकतो ना टिल्टिंग. पॉसिबिलिटी आहे, म्हणजे नाही असं म्हणता येत नाही. राईट? किंवा समुद्रामध्ये काय तर इंटरनल काय तर डिस्टर्बन्स झाले, भरती ओहोटी म्हणतो आपण त्याला, किंवा समुद्रामध्ये समजा लाटा एकदम चेंज काय तर झाल्या त्याच्यामध्ये, तर एखादा समजा मोठा मासा वगैरे असा एकदम एकदम जोरात वेगाने जर गेला, स्विम करत गेला, तर त्याच्यामुळे येणारे डिस्टर्बन्स वॉटरमुळे टिल्ट काही होऊ शकते त्याच्यावर. पॉसिबिलिटी आहे. एम आय राईट? एम आय राईट ना?
येस सर, येस सर.
ओके, अंडरस्टूड दिस मेटा सेंटर? व्हॉट इज माय मेटा सेंटर? अंडरस्टूड ऑर नॉट? राईट, राईट इन चॅट बॉक्स ऑर सम टेल. येस,
हॅलो सर.
You can ask.
सर, मेटा सेंटर फुल्ली इमर्ज्ड बॉडीला असू शकते का सर, किंवा फक्त फ्लोटिंग बॉडीला असू शकते?
जनरली त्याचा इक्विलिब्रियम आपण फ्लोटिंग बॉडीशीच काढतो. सबमरीन बॉडीला पण असू शकतो मेटा सेंटर, पण इन दॅट केस कमी असतो सबमरीन बॉडीला. म्हणजे आत जी बॉडी सबमरीन झाली असते त्या जनरली सीच्या बॉटमला वगैरे जातात, त्यामुळे आपण फ्लोटिंग बॉडीचं इक्विलिब्रियम काढतानाच आपण जनरली मेटा सेंटर आपण कन्सिडर करतो. अदरवाइज सबमर्ज बॉडीला फक्त बॉयन्सी फोर्स आणि सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी फोर्स आपण ते ठरवतो. कारण फ्लोटिंग बॉडी सबमर्ज बॉडीला काय ते डिस्टर्बन्स जरी झालं तर ते बॉडी आतमध्येच असते, सबमर्ज झालेली असते, त्यामुळे जनरली आपण फ्लोटिंग बॉडीला मेटा सेंटर जास्त कन्सिडर करतो. फ्लोटिंग बॉडीला, फ्लोटिंग बॉडीला पण आपण टिल्ट केली बॉडी समजा त्यानुसार जर ती ऑसिलेट होत असेल आतमध्ये तर त्याला मेटा सेंटर असणार, पण ऑसिलेट होत नसेल आपण नुसतं त्याला फक्त ते त्याची कंडिशन जी आहे ती फक्त सेंटर ऑफ बॉयन्सी आणि सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी ठरवली जाते. आणि फ्लोटिंग बॉडी झाल्यानंतर आपण येणार आहे इक्विलिब्रियमला. पण पहिल्यांदा तुम्ही हे समजलंय सांगा, आपण तुमचे जे क्वेश्चन आहेत ते पुढच्या आर्टिकलचे. दिस एव्हरी वन अंडरस्टूड, शॅल वी गो टू नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. नाउ अनदर आर्टिकल इज मेटासेंट्रिक हाइट. ओके, नाउ हियर मेटासेंट्रिक हाइट इज नथिंग बट हियर इट इज द डिस्टन्स बिटवीन द सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी जी ऑफ फ्लोटिंग बॉडी अँड मेटासेंटर एम. याचं जे व्हर्टिकल डिस्टन्स आहे सेंटर, दिस डिस्टन्स दिस इज कॉल्ड एज व्हॉट, एम, मेटासेंटर अँड सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी. हे दिस डिस्टन्स इज कॉल्ड एज this distance. So this mg distance is called as metacentric height. So it is the distance between, simple metacentric height, it is the distance between the center of gravity g of a floating body, the floating body is a, and the metacenter m. म्हणजे metacenter m म्हणजे काय, new buoyancy axis, center of buoyancy तयार झाली, त्याचा जो axis perpendicular axis जो आहे त्यातून जाणारा, आणि original center of gravity चा आपल्या ओरिजिनल सीजीचा, सीजीतून ऍक्सिस पासिंग थ्रू सीजी, याचा जे इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंटला आपण काय म्हणतोय, वेअर कॉनेट एज ए मेटा सेंटर, अँड द डिस्टन्स बिटवीन एम अँड जी, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज युअर मेटासेंट्रिक हाईट. नाऊ द पोझिशन ऑफ मेटा सेंटर ऑर द मेटासेंट्रिक हाईट विल टेल अस वेदर द बॉडी विल रिमेन स्टेबल, अनस्टेबल ऑर न्यूट्रल. एव्हरीबडी राईट नाऊ मेटासेंट्रिक हाईट, राईट नाऊ डेफिनेशन metacentric height. So definitely I am going to here forward this PPT to you all. Okay, so it is a distance between the center of gravity g of a floating body and metacenter m. Metacenter m and g, so this is called as metacentric height mg. You have understood metacentric height? Write down definition. Metacentric height, it is a distance between the center of gravity g of a floating body and metacenter. And remember that if the examination will be online, maximum questions will be asked on this theory. What is meant by related to Archimedes principle? What is meant by metacenter? What is meant by metacentric height? Then what is stable equilibrium? All these questions, maximum MCQs are going to be asked on this if examination will be online. If offline is there, definitely numericals will be asked on that, but maximum questions will be asking in MCQ for this metacentric height, metacenter. It is a distance between center of gravity g and floating body. Now equilibrium of submerged body. So now there are three kinds of equilibrium conditions. There are what? Three kinds of equilibrium conditions, either for submerged bodies or for a floating body. So this is stability or equilibrium condition means what? It is stability. How the, whether that submerged body will be stable or whether the floating body will stable. So that equilibrium conditions are three. One is called as stable equilibrium. One is called as what? This is called stable equilibrium. Another will be unstable equilibrium, and third will be neutral equilibrium. Okay, so there, for any kind of body, there are three types of equilibrium conditions. Stability of any body, for defining stability, there are three types of equilibrium conditions. Okay, so equilibrium of submerged body as follows. So one is stable equilibrium, another is unstable equilibrium, and third one is neutral equilibrium. And the stability or equilibrium of submerged body is only depends on the two conditions, that is position of center of gravity g and the stability of a submerged body is nothing but what, here it is going to be depends on the two condition, not metacenter. Now here it is going to be, here it's mistake, it is going to be center of buoyancy b and center of gravity g. So it is not metacenter, sorry. So the stability of a submerged body is determined by the location of g and b. G means center of gravity, and axial, here center of buoyancy is B. Now, there are three types of equilibrium condition. One is stable equilibrium, another is unstable equilibrium, and third one is what? Neutral equilibrium. Now, what is stable equilibrium? Now, when the body, submerged body or any floating body is get disturbed or given some angular displacement, then after some time, that body will come to original position. So that body, that kind of equilibrium will be called as what? Stable equilibrium. Will restore to original position. So that type of equilibrium is called as what? Stable equilibrium. Will restore original position. Original position. Okay, an unstable equilibrium is there that body will not restore to original position. Or further heal in that position. So that is called as unstable equilibrium. And neutral equilibrium is that. Dakula. Kaya dala. Gila na, sarangad gila na. Think I will go after this lecture. Neutral equilibrium is there that your body will not heal, but it will take new position if disturbed, it will take new position. Take new position. So here there are three types of equilibrium. Either it is submerged body or floating body. What is first is stable equilibrium. Stable equilibrium is what? If any force, any disturbing force will given to that body, after some time that body will restore to the original position. Unstable equilibrium is there that will not restore to the original position, but here it will further ajun tyachyamadhye kay karil ti ajun tashis heal hot rahil disturb hot rahil tya direction la, that is called as unstable equilibrium. And next last is there neutral equilibrium. Neutral equilibrium means what? In this position if body is get disturbed, the wind force kiwa disturb zali tar in that case it will take new position. It will not further heal, or it will not over here, instead of one position it will take another position. So that is called as neutral equilibrium. Now stable equilibrium condition is that here g, for this g is below center of gravity, should be below here center of buoyancy b, means this condition. Afterwards little theoretical. So this is going to be buoyancy, center of buoyancy is b, so or center of gravity is going to be in a downward direction and center of buoyancy is a upward direction. So that condition also here, that will be the represent the stable equilibrium condition of a submerged body. And remember that submerged body's equilibrium condition depends on the two positions. One is B and another is G. B means position of center of buoyancy and G is position of center of gravity. Now stable equilibrium condition, B is above, or in that case you can remember B is above or G is below B. For a total immersed body, the G and B is fixed. The stability of submerged body can be determined by the locations of G and B. Let a balloon completely submerged in air, where W is the weight of the balloon, FB is buoyancy force. For equilibrium condition of balloon, FB is equal to W. Okay. Now I will explain after in the figure. Now unstable equilibrium condition is that when here exact opposite to this. Here it is going to be B. Here जी इज अबोव द सेंटर ऑफ बॉयंसी पोजिशन बी दिस रिप्रेजेंट और जी इज अबोव बी हियर दिस रिप्रेजेंट अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम कंडीशन इफ द बलून इज गिवन स्मॉल एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट थीटा इन क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन देन डब्ल्यू एंड एफ बी प्रोड्यूस ए कपल एक्टिंग इन सेम डायरेक्शन ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट सो दैट बॉडी डज नॉट रिटर्न टू इट्स ओरिजिनल पोजिशन दिस कॉल्ड एज अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम सो जी शुड बी अबोव बी एंड लास्ट वन इज देयर न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम द जी एंड बी आर एट द सेम पोजिशन सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वॉट न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम जी एंड बी आर सेम ओके नाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट थियोरेटिकली नाउ दीज आर गोइंग टू बी कंडीशंस ओके नाउ लेट अस कंसीडर दैट दिस इज गोइंग टू बी एयर एंटायर एटमोस्फियर इज देयर एंड दिस फ्री सर्फेस ऑफ एंटायर एटमोस्फियर मीन्स व्हाट इज एकदम जिथे ट्रोपोस्फियर वगैरे हे जिथं एअर संपते आणि निर्वात पोकळी चालू होते ती जी सर्फेस आहे दॅट वी कॉल्ड एज ए अनादर ॲटमॉस्फिअर इज कॉल्ड एज व्हॉट फ्री सर्फेस दॅट इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ आवर ॲटमॉस्फिअर अँड दॅट ॲटमॉस्फिअर इज कॉल्ड एज फ्री सर्फेस नाव लेट अस कन्सिडर अ स्मॉल बलून इज इमर्स्ड इन अ फ्लूड एअरमध्ये आता सगळे आपण आपण स्वतः सगळे काय झालेलं आहे इमर्स झालेलं आहे लेट अस कन्सिडर दॅट बलून इज इमर्स्ड इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर इन अ एअर ओके Now when this body B, buoyancy force of that balloon is above, center of buoyancy is above than the center of gravity. Okay. So when it will be happen, when balloon you can take and for that balloon, a steam or any small stone, if you attach at its mouth and if you tilt, make that balloon so that stone or steam will be in the downward direction. Okay. So in that case, G will become lower than the B or center of buoyancy will become above. So in this condition, if that balloon is given some angular displacement, to me, there is a tiski marli ta balloon la. Kadi, there is a ta tondala ta dagad banla, and it don't khali kele, and baki ta balloon over kele. And upon that balloon la, to me, tiski marli, disturbed kele. Tar kai huil? Here, that after some time, heater condition asil, kutli, buoyancy force center of buoyancy of that balloon is above and here center of gravity is below then in that condition what will happen if to me the balloon la jar to me clockwise direction la jar to me balloon la rotation dilo then what will happen now due to the clockwise rotation there will be change in buoyancy position and gravity position and in that condition what will happen one couple is going to be formed due to न्यू पोजिशन ऑफ सेंटर ऑफ बॉयन्सी बी अँड सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी जी ह्याच्या एक काय होणार सेंटर ऑफ इथं एक अशा पद्धतीचं जर आपण कपल इकडं आपण रोटेशन दिलं त्याला ओके टिल्ट केली बॉडी तर इथल्या बॉडीपासून काय होणार बी पासून एक साधारणतः एफ बी फोर्स असा ऍक्ट होणार नवीन जर पोजिशन चेंज झाल्यामुळे एक एफ बी कपल आणि जी मधून एक काय होणार ग्रॅव्हिटी फोर्स जी नुसार काय होणार वेट इज गोइंग टू बी ऍक्टिंग इन डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन तर ज्यावेळेस आपण बलूनला क्लॉकवाईज डायरेक्शनची रोटेशन देतो त्यावेळेस काय होते तर इथून एक कपल तयार होते असं ह्याचं जी आणि डब्ल्यू मुळे तयार होणार रिझल्ट कपल आहे दॅट विल ऍक्ट इन द वी डायरेक्शन नाऊ इन द अँटी क्लॉकवाईज डायरेक्शन हे बघा ह्याच्या ह्या डायरेक्शन बलूनची ही डायरेक्शन आहे कपल इज गोइंग टू बी ऍक्ट इन द डायरेक्शन अपोजिट टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन कशामुळे कपल तयार झालं तर न्यू पोझिशन ऑफ सेंटर ऑफ बॉयन्सी बी मधून आणि दुसरी म्हणजे ग्रॅव्हिटी चेंज झाल्यामुळे जीच्या पोझिशन मधून वेट पण थोडं डिस्टर्ब होणार तर वेट आणि बॉयंट फोर्स एफ याच्यामुळे एक कपल तयार होईल दॅट कपल विल ऍक्ट इन विच डायरेक्शन इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन आपली डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन कुठली आपली क्लॉकवाईज ओके तर त्या केसमध्ये काय होईल ते डील झालेलं कपल इज गोइंग टू बी फॉर्म जी पोजिशन असल्यामुळे आणि बॉयंट पोजिशन असल्यामुळे कपल इज गोइंग टू बी फॉर्म इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन अँड दिस कपल विल ब्रिंग दॅट बॉडी टू द ओरिजिनल पोजिशन ओके मीन्स इन द स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन वेन जी इज बिलो बी इन दॅट केस व्हॉट विल हॅपन द कपल फॉर्मड ड्यू टू द डिस्टर्ब्ड फोर्सेस ऑर न्यू पोजिशन इन द न्यू पोजिशन विल ऍक्ट इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन अँड दिस विल ब्रिंग, हे जर रोटेशन क्लॉकवाईज असेल तर कपलचं रोटेशन काय असणार आहे, अँटी क्लॉकवाईज, अँड ड्यू टू दिस व्हॉट विल हॅपन, दिस बॉडी विल कम टू द ओरिजिनल पोझिशन. ओके, सेकंड कंडिशन इज देअर दॅट हिअर वेन, हिअर वेन जी, when g is above b or b is below g, okay, second condition is there that b is above g. So in same here b is above g, kadhi will b is above g, let us consider second condition I am drawing here. Let us consider this as balloon. Okay, now when, आता हे माउट आपण इथे खाली घेतलं होतं, इथं आपण माउट जर आपण आता काय घेतलं वर घेतलं, समजा इथं आपल्याला स्टिंग लावली लोरी आणि काय माउट वर घेतलं इन दॅट केस, आणि इथं काय केलं आपण किंवा इथं वेट वरच्या बाजूला लावलं, आता जर वर काय होणार, वेट वरच्या बाजूला असल्यामुळे काय होणार, सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी जी इज गोइंग टू बी शिफ्ट इन द अपर डायरेक्शन. आता मगाशी आपण त्या फुग्याचं जे तोंड होतं त्या दोरा किंवा त्याला आपण दगड लावलाय किंवा एखादी वेट लावलंय आणि ते वेट काय केले कॉइन लावलं तर ते खाली ठेवले, आता वेट आपण काय केले वर ठेवलंय, आपण आता वर, आता खाली नाही ठेवलं वर ठेवलंय, आणि बॉयन्सी फोर्स मग काय होणार, डेफिनेटली सेंटर ऑफ बॉयन्सी बी विल बी लाय बिलो जी, म्हणजे वेटच जर ग्रॅव्हिटी वेटचे जर आपण वर ऍड केलं तर त्याचं काय होणार, वेट जसे सी जी विल असो शिफ्ट इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन, आणि त्या केसमध्ये काय होईल, त्या केसमध्ये वेन जी इज अबो बी आणि जर त्याला आपण रोटेशन दिलं आपण क्लॉकवाईज दिलं समजा त्याला, तर काय होईल, आता जी वर आहे आणि काय एफ बी खाली आहे, म्हणजे इथे काय होणार टिल्ट मध्ये काय होणार, इथे इट गोइंग टू बी जी, आता जी ला वेट काय होणार, इट इज ऍक्टिंग इन द डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शन, आणि इथं बी कुठला पॉइंट बी आहे, त्या बी मधून जाणार बी, असा असा बी जर वेट, आता याच्यामधून पुन्हा रिझल्ट आता अशी पोझिशन होणार की बी एफ बी, बी मधून एफ बी फोर्स ऍक्ट होतोय आणि जी मधून वेट फोर्स डब्ल्यू, याच्यामधून जे कपल होणार आहे, आता याच्यामधून जे कपल होणार आहे तयार, ते कसं होणार आहे, इट इज ऍक्टिंग इन द सेम डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन, इट ऍक्टिंग इन द सेम डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन, आणि सेम डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन असल्यामुळे काय होईल, दॅट कपल विल नॉट ब्रिंग दॅट बॉडी टू द ओरिजिनल पोझिशन, कपल विल नॉट ब्रिंग दॅट बॉडी टू द ओरिजिनल पोझिशन, इन्स्टीड ऑफ दॅट, इन्स्टीड ऑफ दॅट, दॅट कपल विल हेल्प बॉडी टू हिल, म्हणजे पुन्हा टू फर्दर रोटेट इन द सेम डायरेक्शन, अँड दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज व्हॉट, अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम, दॅट बॉडी विल नॉट रिस्टोअर the original position, or that body will not come to the original position. So that kind of equilibrium is called as unstable equilibrium. Everybody getting? So couple, in that case, couple is formed due to the disturbed force. Couple is formed due to the disturbed position of G and B in the same direction of rotation. Clockwise direction, same direction of rotation. And due to that, here what will happen? Due to that, the body will rotate in the further in that same direction, and that is called as here unstable equilibrium. So unstable equilibrium, what is the condition here, g, if the body is, g is above b or b is below g, so first is what, here b is above g, kai pan get me first condition, b is above g, your body is the center of buoyancy is above b, is above g, which kind of equilibrium body will go for, submerged body, we are speaking about now submerged bodies, entire body submerged, we are taking example of balloon which is submerged in air, and second example is that here b is below g, asa kay tar ek condition aplya pencil mali condition ahe, g computer tal b is below g. Okay, in this case what will that unstable equilibrium. unstable fluid. And last condition is there that it is going to be third condition is there that B and G are at the same point.
Sequence has maintained वाला पाइजे का.
Yes. B and G are at the same point. B and G are at the same point. तर याच्यामध्ये जर झालं काय झालं आता बी आणि जी आर ऍट द सेम पॉइंट आर कोइन्साइडिंग ओके तर याच्यामध्ये इथे दिलंय बी अँड जी आर कोइन्साइडिंग मीन्स वाटलं आपण तर ह्या बॉडीला जर आपण डिस्टर्ब केलं जिथं बॉयन्सी फोर्स पण त्याला काय आहे आणि वेट ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी सेम आहे तर त्या केसमध्ये जर आपण ते बॉडीला डिस्टर्ब केलं तर ती बॉडी टिल्ट वगैरे काय होत नाही तर काय होईल इट विल डायरेक्टली ऑक्युपाय द न्यू पोझिशन ते बलून जर तुम्ही घेतला तसा ज्याच्यामध्ये जी आणि बी सेम आहे त्या बोलून जर तुम्ही डिस्टर्ब केलं तर इट विल नॉट रोटेट बट इट विल व्हॉट युअर ऑक्युपाय द न्यू पोझिशन दुसऱ्या पोझिशनला जाईल आणि तिथं जाऊन स्टेबल होईल दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम कधी न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम असेल बी अँड जी आर कोइन्साइडिंग विथ इच अदर एव्हरीबडी अंडरस्टूड आय विल रिपीट वन्स अगेन नाऊ हियर आय विल गो हियर स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम मध्ये काय होतंय बी इज अबोव जी त्याच्यामुळे काय होईल की बॉडी इज गिव्हन अँग्युलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट इन क्लॉकवाईज डायरेक्शन तर ड्यू टू disturbed due to the new positions of buoyancy and gravity a couple is going to be formed which is formed in the opposite direction of rotation and will restore will make the body to bring to the original position म्हणजे जे कपल तयार होणार जर अपोजिट डायरेक्शन असेल तरच ते काय होईल बॉडी विल कम टू द ओरिजिनल पोझिशन अँड सेकंड इज देअर दॅट अनस्टेबल ज्याच्यामध्ये जी इज अबो बी और बी इज बिलो जी त्याच्यामध्ये काय होईल ही बॉडी इज गिव्हन सम डिस्टर्बड विथ सम अँग्युलर फोर्स विथ सम फोर्स देन व्हॉट विल हॅपन बॉडी विल नॉट कम टू द ओरिजिनल पोझिशन बिकॉज कपल फॉर्मड ड्यू टू वेट अँड बॉयंट फोर्स विल ऍक्ट इन द सेम डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन डायरेक्शनच्या रोटेशनच्या सेम होईल त्यामुळे ते काय होईल कपल त्या बॉडीला परत माघारे आणायच्याऐवजी काय करतील त्याला मदत करतील हिलिंगसाठी किंवा डिस्टर्बड कंडिशन मध्ये राहण्यासाठी दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम अँड थर्ड वन इज व्हॉट न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम जी अँड बी आर ऍट सेम पॉइंट आणि इफ द बलून इज गिव्हन स्मॉल अँग्युलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट या पोझिशनला कधी जी अँड बी असेल तर इन देर इज नो एनी कपल प्रोड्युस्ड सिन्स डब्ल्यू अँड एफ बी आर ऍक्टिंग ऍट सेम पॉइंट अँड बॉडी इज सेट टू बी न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम आणि इट विल ऑक्युपाय द न्यू पोझिशन सो एव्हरीबडी अंडरस्टँड द अँड बिफोर दॅट हिअर देर आर सबमर्ज बॉडीज इक्विलिब्रियम डिपेंड्स ऑन और स्टॅबिलिटी ऑफ सबमर्ज बॉडी इज डिटरमाइंड बाय लोकेशन ऑफ जी अँड बी ओके आणि त्याच्या तीन कंडिशन अंडरस्टूड अंडरस्टूड यस यस ओनली टू थ्री व्हेरी गुड मला बरं वाटतंय असं ओके व्हेरी गुड अदर्स प्लीज रिप्लाय नाउ अनादर टाइप ऑफ बॉडी आर फ्लोटिंग बॉडीज आता आपण सगळं बघितलं तर काय सबमर्ज बॉडीज बघितलं आता आपण वी आर गोइंग टू सी नाउ द इक्विलिब्रियम और स्टॅबिलिटी ऑफ ए फ्लोटिंग बॉडीज अँड नाऊ स्टॅबिलिटी ऑफ सबमर्ज बॉडीज डिपेंड्स ऑन पोझिशन ऑफ जी अँड बी नाऊ द स्टॅबिलिटी देर आर ऑल्सो थ्री काइंड ऑफ स्टॅबिलिटीज आर देर वन इज स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन अनदर इज अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन अँड थर्ड वन इज व्हॉट न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन वन इज स्टेबल अनदर इज अनस्टेबल अँड थर्ड वन इज न्यूट्रल सेम स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन काय होईल बॉडी विल कम टू द बॉडी इज गेट डिस्टर्ब कम टू द ओरिजिनल पोझिशन अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन बॉडी विल नॉट कम टू द ओरिजिनल पोझिशन बट इट विल हील याला काय म्हणतो हील फर्दर इन सेम डायरेक्शन हील म्हणजे तशीच ते डिस्टर्ब कंडिशनला हलत राहते डिस्टर्ब होत राहते हील इन द सेम डायरेक्शन अँड न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम हेअर वॉटले आपण द बॉडी विल ऑक्युपाय न्यू पोझिशन नाऊ इक्विलिब्रियम ऑफ फ्लोटिंग बॉडी डिपेंड्स ऑन द टू कंडीशन. जी कॉमन आहे दोन्ही कंडीमध्ये पण, सबमर्ज मध्ये पण आणि फ्लोटिंग मध्ये पण. सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी पोझिशन इज कॉमन इन बोथ. ओके, अँड बट फॉर फ्लोटिंग बॉडी इन्स्टेड ऑफ बॉयन्सी पोझिशन वी आर कन्सिडरिंग एज ए यम. व्हॉट इज दिस यम इज कॉल्ड एज? एनीबडी कोण लक्ष देत आहे? व्हॉट इज दिस यम इज कॉल्ड? मेटा सेंटर. ओके, व्हेरी गुड. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी द स्टॅबिलिटी ऑफ ए फ्लोटिंग बॉडी इज डिटरमाइंड बाय द लोकेशन ऑफ जी अँड मेटा सेंटर पोझिशन ऑफ फ्लोटिंग बॉडी यम. आणि ह्याच्या देर आर ऑल्सो थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम ऑफ फ्लोटिंग बॉडी. वन स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम, अनस्टेबल. सो इन एमसीक्यू विल आस्क स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ ए फ्लोटिंग बॉडी डिपेंड्स ऑन वॉट? जी अँड यम. अँड स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ सबमर्ज बॉडी डिपेंड्स ऑन एनीबडी? जी अँड बी. करेक्ट. जी अँड बी मीन्स सेंटर ऑफ बॉइंस. ओके, नाउ सेम कंडिशन, ओनली बी वी हैड रिप्लेस बाय जी. हियर स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन काय? व्हेन मेटा सेंटर इज अबोव जी, व्हेन मेटा सेंटर इज अबोव जी व्हाट विल हैपन? अँड डब्ल्यू इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन, इक्विलिब्रियम असल्यामुळे डब्ल्यू इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू बी बिकॉज इट इज इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन, रिमेंबर दॅट. ओके, सो इफ फ्लोटिंग बॉडी कधी ह्या कंडिशन मध्ये कुठल्या, व्हेन मेटा सेंटर इज अबोव जी अँड डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू बी इक्विलिब्रियम कंडिशन, if the floating body is given small angular displacement theta in clockwise direction, then center of buoyancy shift from b to b1 and the buoyant force fb through b1 and w produces a couple acting in anticlockwise direction, hence floating body returns to its original position. So floating body said to be in stable equilibrium kadi javelis m is above g, when m is above g and w is equal to fb, and in that case if you disturb that body given some angular displacement in clockwise direction, then what will happen? The couple is going to be formed due to the FB passing through B1 and W here passing through G produces a couple acting in anti-clockwise direction, opposite direction of rotation. Clockwise is another, the couple is going to be formed in anti-clockwise direction. Sorry, couple is going to be formed in couple. Is formed in anti-clockwise direction, couple, and this is rotation direction is rotation is clockwise. So couple is going to be formed in anti-clockwise direction and body will not will come to the original position kai vela nantar original position, that is called as stable equilibrium, and when m is above g. Same now unstable equilibrium, when equilibrium mante manlyavar apan what we are going to say, as you were saying equilibrium condition W is equal to FB, equilibrium W is equal to FB, M is below G, M is below G, okay, M is below G, and in this condition W is FB and M is below G, if the floating body is given small angular displacement theta in clockwise direction, then FB and W produce a couple acting in clockwise direction, hence overturning. Overturning means it is disturbing in the same direction, so it body will not come to the original position. So M should be, if M is below G, in that case M, G is above and M is below, then again what will happen? Couple is going to be formed which will act in the same direction of rotation. Clockwise, the other to me rotation you were given clockwise, and couple is also going to be act in the same direction, it is clockwise direction, and body will not come to the, that floating body will not come to the original position because couple is acting in the same direction, body will heel in further in that direction. And neutral equilibrium again, when M and G are at the same point, if you say that M and G, then body will not come to the original position. M and G are at the same position, then M and G are at the same point, then body will not come to the in that case, if disturbance is given to the body, instead of tilting, it will occupy new position because couple is not going to be formed. No, if couple is going, there is no any couple produced due to W and FB, since W and FB are at the same point, and floating body is said to be neutral equilibrium. Body will occupy new position. Occupy new position. बॉडी विल ऑक्यूपाई न्यू पोजिशन. ओके तो हियर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ नो इज एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ बी इज अबाउट जी सबमर्ज्ड बॉडी एफ बी ओके वेट ओके now if the screen is visible little bit so now here g is ek example apan karto hai tya anusar ami tumhala okay if g is above b or b is above g in that position what will happen now here accelerate this is u g now the body is given tilt therefore this g will through this g weight is acting okay now due to tilting another axis for this axis the buoyancy will get changed to b to b1 is going to be changed and normal axis passing through new buoyancy and original axis passing through center of gravity intersection of this we are called as a meta center now in this position what will happen m is above g yeah position la tar m is above g tar kay will the but due to the new position the b1 madun ek couple act will okay ani w madun itun ek couple w okay ek couple ani dusra kutla new yacha madun b1 and this couple ikade w asena kay will this couple act what is that in actually act in the v direction this couple will act in the opposite direction and body is given rotation clockwise direction ह्या पोजिशन मुळे काय होईल याच्यामुळे द ड्यू टू दिस कपल फॉर्म्ड ड्यू टू न्यू बॉयन्सी बॉयंट फोर्स ऍक्टिंग थ्रू न्यू बॉयन्सी अँड वेट थ्रू सेंटर ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी म्हटलं आपण द कपल इज फॉर्म्ड इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन अँड द बॉडी विल कम टू द ओरिजिनल पोजिशन आता ही जर पोजिशन उलटी असेल जर जी वर असेल आणि एम जर खाली असेल तर काय होईल कपलची डायरेक्शन पण काय होईल उलटी उलटी म्हणजे कुठली सेम डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन and that body will not come to the original position and g and m the same as still tar kay will in that case what will happen here both are same so there is no formation of couple and body will occupy new position instead of tilting this is called as what neutral equilibrium so there are three types of equilibrium condition for either submerged bodies or floating bodies stable equilibrium unstable equilibrium and neutral equilibrium stable equilibrium again I will repeat the body will come to the original position both okay when body will come to original position when due to new position couple is going to be formed due to center of buoyancy due to buoyant force and weight force evad lakshyatva due to buoyant force and buoyancy force and weight force in opposite direction of rotation stable in opposite due to the opposite direction of rotation the body will come to the original position second unstable equilibrium when couple is going to be produced due to new buoyant force and weight here what will happen couple is produced in the same direction of rotation due to that what will happen the body will not come to the original position but it will further heel in that position that is called as unstable equilibrium and neutral both are at the same point both point couple no couple is formed body is disturbed the disturbed ke liye kya will it will occupy the new position or a simple I am giving an example our general example ekara samjhe ek mitra a mitra hai okay ani ek b ek mitra hai samjha a la kai tari white savai hai a la kai tari samjha white savai hai ani samjha b a la dar त्या ओरिजिनल ट्रॅकवर आणायचं असेल आपल्याला ट्रॅकवर तर बी कसा पाहिजे आपल्याला चांगल्या सवयीचा पाहिजे का वाईट सवयीचा पाहिजे एनी मॉडी ऑफ यू काय पाहिजे चांगल्या सवयीचा जर तो चांगल्या सवयीचा असेल चांगल्या सवयी जर डॉमिनेट झाल्या तर तो मित्राला वाईट सवयी आणू शकतो म्हणजे ती काय झाली आपली स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम आणि अनस्टेबल म्हणजे काय तर ए ला वाईट हे आहेत सवयी आहेत पी असा आहे की त्याला पण वाईट सवयी आहेत तर बी ए ला आणू शकेल का ट्रॅकवर? ट्रॅकवर आणू शकेल का प्लीज? नाही. कादर काय होईल मग दोघांच्या वाईट सवयीचा काय होईल, समेशन होऊन वेगळ्या ते दोघंही काय होतील त्या ट्रॅक पासून जास्त लांब जातील. दॅट इज कॉल्ड अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम. न्यूट्रल म्हणजे काय, दोघंही चांगले आहेत आणि मग दोघांना डिस्टर्ब केलं तर होत नाही पण दे विल प्रोग्रेस, दॅट विल न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम. तर एव्हरीबडी गॉट स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम, बॉडी कम्स टू द ओरिजिनल पोझिशन. कधी त्यासाठी रिक्वायरमेंट काय, कपल फॉर्म्ड, कपल फॉर्म्ड ड्यू टू द वेट अँड बॉयंट फोर्स. ओके, ऑर इट शुड बी ऍक्ट इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन, बॉडी विल कम टू द ओरिजिनल पोझिशन. स्टेबल अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम, कपल फॉर्म्ड ड्यू टू वेट अँड बॉयंट फोर्स इन सेम डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन, इन सेम डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन body will not come to the original position, it will further heal in the same direction. And neutral, both points are at the, both are at the same point. The body, if the disturbance is given, the body will occupy the new position. Understood? Understood zala asel tar yes mana. This completes our theory of first chapter, means part unit 1. Understood? Please write yes. Very good, very good. Yes, yes. Now I will show, I will now upload both PPTs, first PPT as well as this PPT on our group. Shall I now only upload? And I will remaining time, what is time now? 11:35. So I am 20, at least I will 20 minutes. So 1 or 2 numericals you solve. So now I will ask you your attendance and definitely in this case, I will upload 2 PPTs, this PPT as well as our first PPT. Okay, and here you have to solve some numericals on from the assignment, and answers you have to tell on my WhatsApp. My WhatsApp number is everybody know. Okay, now we'll go for attendance.